In this lesson, we'll discuss how vulnerability data from both either QRadar Vulnerability Manage or third-party scanners can be incorporated into the QRadar SIEM product. In addition to managing log event and flow data, QRadar also maintains a database of observed assets. Assets in QRadar represent systems that are communicating across certain ports that may map to services or applications. The source for this asset data predominantly comes from observed network flow traffic, but can also come from various logs such as DHCP and DNS server logs. Since the asset record contains vital information about operational systems observed in the environment, QRadar can incorporate data from third-party vulnerability scanners to further enhance the asset records. The information that comes in from vulnerability scans can also be used in the rules engine. For instance, if we observe traffic going to a HTTP port on a particular server and there's an associated vulnerability, the overall scoring of the event may go up. IBM also markets a vulnerability scanner that is an enhancement to the QRadar product. If you're licensed for QRadar Vulnerability Manager, you would see a new tab appear in the QRadar admin console entitled Vulnerabilities. By using base QRadar SIEM functionality, asset profile data will contain information about systems based on what has been observed in the environment. By enhancing this data with the usage of vulnerability scanner data, the asset profile database will give you a complete picture of what's occurring in your environment and perhaps how you may be vulnerable to certain types of attacks. In summary, this unit covered the basic aspects of event and flow data collection, as well as the incorporation of information from third-party scanners or IBM's QRadar Vulnerability Manager product.